Ladies and gentlemen, His Holiness, the Venerable 14th Dalai Lama Ji. Please stand.
I usually, you see, frankly speaking, I don't like too much formality. When we're born, no formality. At the time of death, also no formality. So, while we're alive, I feel just normal way. So, I always, you see, start talk, respected brothers and rest of the brothers, sisters. I really feel under this cloth, it's the same human body, same human brain. Me also, same. So we entire 7 billion human being, mentally, emotionally, physically, we are same. We are truly brothers, sisters. Then according to your belief, we all created by God. When we describe God, infinite love, oh, wonderful. So, from that viewpoint, we all brothers, sisters of children, one Father. That is infinite love. So, if you really, seriously, you see, follow that teaching, that concept, then no basis killing each other. We all come from same Father. That Father, infinite love. So in our genes, the God's infinite love, some sort of karada, treasure genes, right? They are wonderful. So we are truly brothers, sisters. Then, scientifically, we are social animal. Each individual's life depends on the rest of the community. So without community, one single person cannot survive. So now modern time, in economy field, global economy, no national boundary. And on top of that, now global warming. Also, you see, we entire world facing same, no differences of different continent, different nations. So now global warming, I think, become something quite serious. Within my lifetime, due to global warming, the less snow. In Tibet also, you see, we observed in early part of 20th century, a lot of snow, gradually less and less. After I came to India, settled at Dharamsala, who was around now 60 years, much change, much less snowfall. And these are the clear indication, global warming. Then nature disaster also increasing, and such period, such sort of situation. Now fighting, killing, on the basis of different nationality, different country. And worst thing, due to different faith, killing. worst thing, because all major religious tradition really caring message of love, and all spiritual brothers, sisters. However, now today's world, there are cases killing human brothers, sisters, each other on the name of religion. Unthinkable. In human society, because of this marvelous intelligence, marvelous brain, firstly language developed, then with that script, and the many different concepts, you see, can explain through language. So we human beings, I think through centuries, because of this intelligence, I think human brain, I think much developed with the help of education. Now here, when you mentioned Sindhu's name, I really felt, oh, these people really serve for education. So they are physical no longer, but they are the fruit of their work really there. So really grateful. And these people, according to Christianity, no question, today they may in heaven. Okay. So now this different faith, different tradition, you see, different concept. So I may share one funny story. The Kursakumindi, Bishop Tutu, South African, a Nobel laureate, a wonderful spiritual practitioner, Christian teacher, wonderful. So, whenever we met, he always described me, mischievous Dalai Lama. And I returned, mischievous bishop. Quite equal. And then, one occasion, you see, we have serious discussions, about 3 days. And then one occasion, he mentioned to me, or teasing me, he, as a Christian practitioner, Christian believer, he ready go to heaven. Then look at me. You go some different place. So strictly speaking, we are non-believer. No concept of God, creator. So, strictly speaking, very sinful, so go to hell. So in any way, I got sort of certain these really dedicated people, I think really, according to their faith, I think must be in heaven. So now, the human being, this marvelous brain, like sophisticated machine. The important thing is that machine or scientific knowledge, either use destructive way or constructive way. That depends on motivation. Like nuclear physics, nuclear weapon, Newton bomb. Great achievement from scientific sort of research. but then used for killing, for destruction. It's very bad. So, similarly, this marvelous intelligence used for destruction. And then, very sad, other animal, tigers, lions, so on, meat eater, they always attack other animal. But very limited destruction. When they feel hungry, then they, for their survival, attack. But we human beings, in our history, killing each other. War in human history. War means mobilized violence. In human history, east, west, everywhere, part of human history. Because of this intelligence. And we develop weapon and organized force to kill. Very sad. So now, our recent century, 20th century, too many killing through war, through violence. Now, it is our generation's responsibility. Now, the 20th century is sort of, situation, killing. First World War, Second World War, and then Korean War, Vietnam War, and even the beginning of this 21st century, the traces of previous centuries, habit, killing. Whenever we face some disagreement, we always rely on use force. That's the traces of 20th century. Now we should think, we should try. This 21st century should be peaceful century. In order to develop peaceful century, we should create this century more compassionate century. It is scientifically say, basic human nature is more compassionate. Then, according to our daily experience, when you sit with people smiling, ready, helping each other, you feel very happy. You are surrounded by people who suspect you, something like that. You never be happy. We are a social animal. We need a group of people who really showing you affection, care, caring. So, irrespective of whether religious-minded people or not, even anti-religious people, they also need a friend. They also born from their mother. So, therefore, we as a human being, as a social animal, and with this marvelous intelligence, now we really need some sort of effort to create warm-heartedness. Intelligence alone, no guarantee whether bring happy life or not, happy society or not. So this marvelous intelligence combined with warm-heartedness, that means a sense of love. All religion carry that message. So now this is on Christian college, wonderful. Now this real message of Jesus Christ is love, that you should be part of our life. That's very important. With that, more intelligence and more education. And then that education could be a constructive way, constructive education. Education with anger, jealousy, hatred, then very dangerous. So I really appreciate all those the generation who really serving humanity through this college. So really wonderful. Now from this college, how many people who really become useful to the society, effective service to the society, so many people. So this is the result or product of this college or university. So I really appreciate. Now the younger generation, you should be 21st century's human being. Education or heartedness, these two things very important. Just education combined with hatred, anger, no good. So we should learn what happened in the 20th century. How many people killed through war? According to some historian, they say nearly 200 millions of people killed through violence. So that kind of situation should not repeat on this 21st century. So the younger generation, please think, firstly, education, and combine with om heartedness. That's very important. Now scientifically, now some scientists say, more anger here, constant anger, constant stress is actually eating our immune system. So then we are a social animal, we love smile. So anger there, no longer smile. With anger, even some smile, that's the artificial smile. Sometimes creates more suspicion. Too much artificial smile. or I think you hear diplomatic smile. So genuine human smile automatically come with love there, sense of concern of others' well-being, then smile come. So more compassionate mind, very good for our health. That's now scientists, many scientific research found that. And constant anger actually eating our immune system. So whether believer or non-believer, this warm-heartedness is very important, very useful for individual happiness, healthy body. And with this inner value, you can create happy individual, happy family, through that way, happy community. Education alone, no guarantee. Okay. So, you are religious, sort of connected to education institution. So, you have this sort of what's the ability combine these two things, brain development and development of heartedness. Thank you.